So the first question here, I said the function is increasing or decreasing. Increasing, dy by dx is positive. Decreasing, dy by dx is negative. Here it says prove that this is increasing on R, means on a set of real number. That means for any real number, this function will always be positive. Okay, so let y be this. I said if it is given, fine, otherwise let it be y. Differentiating with respect to x, so dy by dx, I got differentiation of this, simplified it, I got x minus 2 whole square. Now square of a negative number is always positive, it's very commonly known to you. So this is always positive for any real number, right? So we have to prove that this is increasing, so this is increasing, right? So this is simple sum, maybe of 2 marks. Another sum, well, here, find the maximum and minimum value of the function. I have written 2. I'm doing the first one. So let y be this. So what I said, first find dy by dx, so differentiate. Differentiating it with respect to x. We got this. So first step, differentiate. Then I said equate that to 0. Now before doing it, you must write here for maximum or minimum value. I said this is the necessary condition. So you have to write this, dy by dx is 0. So the second step, I said equate that to 0. So this implies I am taking 3 common. X square minus 4x plus 3 equal to 0. So that is 3 into x minus 1 into, sorry, x plus 1 into x minus 3 equal to 0. I think both minus, so implies x equal to 1 or 3. So we got two values of x. I said you can have more than one value. So there are two values of x, 1 or 3. Third step, what we do? We differentiate further. I'm doing it here, okay? So finding d2y by dx2 will be differentiation of the first answer, that is 3x square minus 12x plus 9, that will be 6x minus 12. Next, what we do, we put the value of x obtained here. So we write here d2y by dx2, two values. So at x equal to 1, will be 6 minus 12, that is minus 6, negative. So if this is negative, y is maximum at x equal to 1. The second value we got, x equal to 3. So dy by dx2 at x equal to 3. So this is 18 minus 12 is equal to 6, positive. So y is minimum at x equal to 3. So these are the steps which we said, I repeat, differentiate first, equate that to 0. But before equating to 0, you must write for maximum and minimal value is equal to 0. Dy by dx is 0. You got the value of x, solve it, number 3. Then differentiate, number 4. Then you put the value of x, 5 and 6. Alright? So 5 and 6. Then I said to find the maximum or minimum value, you put the value of x in the original function. Therefore, maximum value of y, maximum y is maximum at x equal to 1. So put x equal to 1 here, so 1 minus 6 plus 9 minus 8 is minus 4, and minimum value y x equal to 3, so that's 27 minus 54 plus 27 minus 8. So this is minus 8. So this is the maximum value and the minimum value. Is that okay? So this is how we do the sums. But basically, the sums which we will get in the exam is based on mensuration. So better review, revise mensuration formula. We'll come to it. Second one. Now look at this. Now when you differentiate it, you will get a triquadratic equation. It will be 12x cubed minus 12x squared. Okay, so for this, I think you do it. I'm running short of time. So this is h which you get. This will be equated to 0. So x square into x square minus 1 will be 0. So x is equal to 0 plus 1 minus 1 for the second one. Right? So when you equate that to 0, after differentiating, you have three values. Now the question says what? In the closed interval, this sign is indicates the closed interval, means including both the values, minus 1 and 2. So what you will take? You will take minus 1, you will take 0, you will take 1. Right? Because both, all three values comes between this. So you will have three values to substitute here. And for all three values, you will find maximum or minimum. Now look at this sum here. If you put x equal to 0, you may get that as 0, d2y by dx as 0. So when you get at this 0, 0, differentiate it further, as I said, to get d3y by dx3, and then get d4y by dx4 again. If that is not equal to 0, the function is having minimum maximum, otherwise it has a point of inflection. Alright, so wait for the next class. I would like to have a review on this class, please. A very important chapter for 6 marks. So please go through the video. Any doubts, I think you can WhatsApp in the problem. Okay, I'll do some more. Actually, I have not started any sum so far. This is only an example of getting maximum minimum value. So thank you very much.